chiropractor says you have liver cancer doesn't convince me you have liver cancer. I'm so stupid and basic and linear. I need to see some proof before I'm going to start treating somebody. Same is true with the before I start treating someone with pancreatic cancer into the liver based on a zapper, I want to see the proof for the patient's benefit. Why put them through a therapy they don't need? So that's those are the problems I had. Now, in terms of her parasite remedies, of course, artemisinin and cloves and black walnut, these are traditional anti-parasite remedies. But we find very few of our patients have parasites. I mean, I've had some patients with terrible parasites. I had a UN diplomat from England who had developed terrible parasites after eating raw food at a dinner in Malaysia. Boy, did she have real parasites. And we treated her with herbal stuff like black walnut and was fine. So black walnut, very effective. I think parasites are a problem. I think it's overstated.
Okay.
Now, one of the things, having said that, it can be a problem. And if a patient has parasites that need to be treated, one of the issues with parasites, as with candida, usually means there's not enough hydrochloric acid in the body. You know, traditional peoples, that, for example, that Weston Price study, they didn't have parasite medications. And they were eating food that they hunted or they grew locally or harvested locally, and they didn't want dying of parasites. They could fight it off. You know, wild animals, if parasites were deadly, there wouldn't be any wild animals because they're all eating, you know, rotten stuff and old flesh and plants. She can't defend herself, and I respect her, and she tried, and she was persecuted unnecessarily. But she thought everyone should live in a sterile environment where you never eat raw food. Everything should be cooked, because if you eat raw food, you're going to get parasites. Well, we're the only species of animal on Earth that cooks its food. All the wild animals out there are eating raw food, and they're not all wiped out by parasites. You know, the African herds, those wildebeests, those millions of animals, they're all eating raw food and getting parasites. And, well, why aren't they all dying of parasites and getting cancer? They're not. So it just doesn't make any sense. But one of the things is, if you have enough hydrochloric acid, you will tend to kill parasites. And if you have enough hydrochloric acid in the stomach, you'll tend to kill candida. Candida and parasites cannot live in the presence of hydrochloric acid.
So how do we make more hydrochloric acid?
Well, if you have a good nutritional program, hydrochloric acid production in the stomach is a complicated physiological process, and it needs a lot of vitamins and minerals like zinc and magnesium. If you have enough minerals and vitamins, you make a fair amount of hydrochloric acid. Yes, as Jonathan Wright says, as we get older, we tend to get deficient. I take hydrochloric acid. I think anyone over 40 should probably be taking some, and we put all our patients on it. But, you know, most of the people I see are quite sick, so they need hydrochloric acid. Most people over 40 will need some. Hydrochloric acid kills candida, kills parasites. I've had so many patients with terrible candida who've been to 15 different doctors, conventional, alternative, with terrible candida, been on nystatin, ketoconazole, diflucan, still have candida. We put them on hydrochloric acid. 6 weeks later, it's all gone.
Wow.
They can't live in the presence of hydrochloric acid. It kills them. Same was true with parasites. Wild animals have natural protection. Yes, I know there are animals that die of parasites, and they do exist, of course. I understand that. And rabbits can get tularemia and all that stuff. But, you know, the rabbit's population is thriving. And they generally survive, and they usually just hydrochloric acid and gut will tend to knock it out.
It's such a pleasure to talk with you. You're a lot of fun. You're interesting. You're feisty. I love it.
Yeah, I hope I didn't do too much damage.
No, not at all. I mean, it's interesting, and some of it is difficult. You can only imagine what it's like for the public. Let's finish with this. The diligent public, the committed public, who's dedicated to their health and well-being and optimizing their health, really has a challenge today.
They have a challenge. Look, you read John Lee's book from 20 years ago. Progesterone was magic. It would get rid of fibroids, ovarian cysts, fibrocystic breast disease, protect you against breast cancer. And then I started getting patients who were taking progesterone and breast cancer exploded, and their fibroids exploded. I saw two patients in my own practice where their fibroids literally doubled in size on natural progesterone. And I said, whoa. And the problem with so many of these books out there, like Hulda with her
parasites,
approach to cancer, parasites with cancer, liver flukes and cancer, is they get an idea and they present it as truth, and they tend to ignore, just like the conventional doctors, anything that doesn't fit their thesis. One of the things I really respect about Kelly, he said if something works in a patient, you can be guaranteed it's not going to work in the next 100 patients. What you need to do is, with each patient, figure out what they need and what they don't need, and there are no general rules. The one rule in our office, there are no general rules. I have patients we put on fatty red meat 3 times a day, other people on more raw foods, vegetarian, 90 variations of diet, all their supplement protocols are different. Everybody's different. Some people need huge amounts of probiotics, some people need minimal, some people need a lot of hydrochloric acid, some people minimal. Everyone's different. There are no general rules, which creates confusion. Often when I lecture, people get very frustrated because they think the information is wonderful, but then they don't know what to do in their particular situation.
I can relate to that just listening to you here. But there's a lot of universal things you have said. One having to do with detoxing and taking the coffee enemas daily. Two, about taking sodium alginate, if we can find it. The other one about a probiotic every day. And the rest.
Now, having made it all very complicated, now I'm going to simplify it. People tend to like the foods they should be eating. A genetic meat eater hates salads. And they're forced to eat salads because they're a healthy food. And Pritikin and Orner still dominate our thinking that fat is the enemy of mankind. Nonsense. Lions and tigers eat nothing but fatty red meat, and they never die of heart disease. Eskimos traditionally ate nothing but fatty meat, 80% fat, never died of heart disease. When they started eating Rice Krispies and Western-type foods, that's when they started getting heart disease. People tend to like the foods they should eat because they feel better. A cow wants to eat grass. A cow doesn't want to eat beef stew. A lion is not going to eat grass. I mean, on the Serengeti Plain, there's grass everywhere. You don't see lions eating grass. And yeah, sometimes they get sick. It helps with nausea. But they basically eat raw meat. That's all they eat. People tend to like the foods they should eat because when they eat the foods they should eat, they tend to feel better. Meat eaters feel great on meat. Vegetarian patients feel better on fruits, vegetables, nuts, seeds, and grains. Balanced people need a variety of foods. I'm balanced, so I do best with a variety of foods. I always crave a variety of foods. Meat eaters don't. They want meat. They want fatty meat. They want bacon for breakfast and fatty roast beef for lunch and steak for dessert. That's what they want. They don't want fruits and veggies. And they shouldn't be eating them. Then they should have some veggies usually. But people tend to like the foods they should. Again, everybody likes chocolate. No, we shouldn't eat a pound of chocolate a day, but people know what I mean, within reason. The trouble is experts arrive on the scene, and they're dictatorial, and they think everyone should be the same, and everyone like Pritikin and Orner should be a vegetarian, or Atkins, everyone should be a meat eater, and Reeven out of Stanford, everyone should be on a balanced diet, whatever that is. But different people need different diets. The Eskimo should not be on a balanced diet. They should be eating fatty red meat and nothing else. And the traditional Eskimo never touched a fruit or a vegetable because there aren't any fruits and vegetables up in the Arctic Circle. So go by your instincts. In terms of supplements, it is tricky. One reason there are a lot of negative studies about, well, a lot of the negative studies are just junk science, but they take a population of people, 10,000 people, put them all on the same dose of an isolated nutrient. That's not the way nutrients work. They work synergistically. They work together as a team, and different people need different doses, different forms. We use 6 different forms of some of our nutrients, and it depends on the patient, which form, which dose. Well, you can experiment with that, and you can always go by how you feel. If you feel worse with a supplement, you shouldn't be on it, whatever some expert or alternative practitioner says. Go by your instincts. If you like fatty red meat and dream about bacon, you need to be on it. If you're repulsed by red meat and dream about salads and feel great after you eat a piece of fruit, you should be more on a plant-based diet. So you can go by your own instincts. It is complicated. The books out there all claim, like Lee's book or Hulda Clark's book, one answer to everything. Anything that's too simple to be true isn't true.
It's very wise. Ladies and gentlemen, we have been talking with, learning from, and listening to Dr. Nicholas Gonzalez. If you would like to learn more about him and pick up his books, you can go to www.drdr-gonzalez.com, or you can contact his office in New York. Go ahead, doctor, give your telephone number, please.
212-213-3337, 212-213-3337.
It's a pleasure to be at the frontier with you, talking with you. Thank you so much.
Great.